Hi everyone, my name is Stefan. I'm a geophysicist, and today I'm going to explain how you can read the charts, graphs, and data on the Space Observing System website. This is a website that is in Russian, which makes it difficult. There's also a lack of kind of indicators, and they collect data out of Tomsk, Russia, and this is in the middle of the Eurasian continental plate, so it's a good place to collect all this space and atmospheric data. A lot of people have trouble reading this data. Specifically, they're looking at how to read the Schumann resonance data because they have all that there. So this is the main website. You have the different categories. This is weather. This is background electromagnetic field, ionospheric stuff. We're not going to touch that today. We will go here. But then you have at the bottom here, Schumannovskaya resonansi. So that's the Schumann data. Then you have chastoti, which is frequency, amplitude, and then dobrodnosti, which is Q factor. So we'll go right in so you can begin to understand how you can read this. It's really simple. You have frequency in hertz on the y-axis, and then you have time in hours on the x-axis. So this is basically frequency plotted against time. And the color represents amplitude. So it's a 3D graph that we're looking at here. And the lower amplitudes are these purples and blues, and the high amplitudes are the whites. Yellow and green are basically in the middle. So the first thing you'll notice is, well, you might notice this first, I'll talk about that. But the first thing is this: these bands for the Schumann resonances. So you have the foundational Schumann resonance here at 7.8. Then you have one here at about 14, and then 20, and 25, 26, and so on and so forth. So barely, you can see one barely here at like 32 or so. So it's pretty clear that the foundational one's the strongest. It has the highest amplitudes. As you can tell, it goes to white and red at some points. And then this next one is stronger, and they kind of die out. They also pulse, as you can tell, depending on what time it is, right? The day-night cycle and atmospheric weather that's nearby. There's a lot of factors that influence the Schumann resonances. This right here could be space weather. What it actually is thunderstorm that's over Tomsk right now, or it was. So you can see it peaked at the hour 16. And if you go here, we can see that we had thunderstorms in Tomsk. And right now it's currently thunderstorms, overcast. So that is the reason for this large amplification of this low frequency 0 to 40 hertz electromagnetic energy. And that actually helps to sustain the Schumann resonance. That's what creates the Schumann resonance in the first place, is these lightning strikes. So this is a good indicator. This helps us understand what's known as the Q factor. So I'll go to the Q factor really quick. Dobrodnosti. And if you have a pendulum that's well greased, that has a high Q factor. It's not going to dampen out easily. Whereas if you have a pendulum that doesn't have any oil on the bearing, it'll dampen out really quickly and therefore it'll stop swinging. That's the Q factor. How well a resonator can keep sustaining itself and how little or how much energy it loses in the process. So we have the Q factors here on the side for the four different modes, foundational going to the higher. We have 4 to 17. And we'll notice that the Q factor here is pretty low, some little spikes, but then it jumps up a lot for all the different modes depending on the time and when that thunderstorm rolled in. So that's what sustains the Schumann resonance. That's what gives the Schumann resonance a continuous replenishment and a higher Q factor. So resonators with high quality factors have low dampening, and therefore they vibrate, ring, resonate for longer. So the higher Q factor you have, the lower rate of energy loss, and oscillations again die out more slowly. So you can see how there's differences in the Q factor between the different modes of the Schumann resonance. So there's patterns and observations that you can start to make if you visit this website consistently, visually observe the data, and kind of mentally log it away. But we'll go to frequency next, the frequency graph. That's chastoti. And this shows the average frequency per time for the different modes. So we have the overall average frequency, but then you have the frequency, the peak frequency, and how it kind of changes for the different modes over time. So you can see this is the foundational going from 7.25 hertz up to 8.04 hertz. And then the explainer for the second mode is on the right side and back and forth. So 12.7 to 14.6 and so on and so forth. So you can see how these peak frequencies for the individual Schumann modes changes over time. And you can start to correlate this with other factors like weather or space phenomenon or what have you. This website is just great at just putting the data out there. They collect the data, they do a good job at it, and then they put it out there. Problem is that's in Russian, so if you speak English and you don't speak Russian, it's difficult to kind of navigate around. Chastoti, amplitude, chastoti frequency, amplitude is amplitude. We'll go there next. This shows the amplitudes of the Schumann resonance. And you'll see that this atmospheric weather, the thunderstorm, caused a huge increase in the amplitudes, the strength of the electromagnetic waves associated with those Schumann resonance frequencies, those bands. And we also notice that the base amplitude that they use to measure the foundational is 4, whereas the other ones, it's all 2. So you can see that the foundational Schumann resonance already has a 2x factor. It's already about 2 times stronger on average in amplitude than these other modes. And that's how physics works typically. But you see the amplitude jumped up dramatically. You'll see the peak amplitude, 68, was actually highest for the foundational, whereas the peak amplitude is 56 for the second mode. And then so on and so forth, 46 for the next one, and 39, lowest amplitude. Peak amplitude for the highest mode that's easily measured. So that falls in line with what we would expect. We expect that foundational Schumann resonance to have the highest amplitude data. And the Schumann resonances aren't changing. Those frequencies are set. When people are saying, is it going to spike to some number like 100 or 150 or 80, whatever, it's the amplitude that they're talking about. Will the Schumann resonance reach this type of amplitude? And you have to remember that if a thunderstorm rolls over Tomps, it's just measuring the amplitude of the Schumann resonance at Tomps. It's not an indication of the global. But when things are quiet in Tomps, the weather's quiet, then it's measuring really the Schumann resonance for a pretty broad area. So that is a little bit of an explainer so you have a better understanding of what's happening here. And I'm going to quickly also show you the Urovienne Electromagnetova Fona, which is the background electromagnetic levels. And this is interesting just because there's some interesting patterns in here. This chart goes from 0 to 30 megahertz, and then also measured across time. We have decibels, so kind of like our amplitude is decibels here, going from 0 to 90. But the biggest thing that I noticed is this bounding electromagnetic higher decibel pulse that occurs over time. So that's likely due to the fact that the Earth has a day and night cycle. I need to research into that more, but you can see it goes from 0 up to 20 and back down is all in megahertz. See some other bands here. That's all interesting. So I hope you found this video explainer useful in understanding how you can read the Schumann resonance graphs. If you like the video, politely click that like button. Put any questions or comments you have in the comments below, and please subscribe for more content like this. And if you haven't already, watch my Schumann resonance What Is It video right here. That should answer a lot of your questions. Hope you all found this useful. Thanks for watching. Ciao. This is Geophysics Explained.